Hey guys, this is Eric Tarr for theproaudiophiles.com. In this video, I'm going to show you a new plugin that I just picked up called the Polarity Maximizer. This is a utility plugin that solves a very specific problem when you're mixing, and that's the issue of phase cancellation and destructive interference. I've already got some other blog posts and videos that you can go and check out where I go into much more detail about what this issue is. But if you have a chance to check those out, I think that'll help you really appreciate what this plugin can do for your mixing. So here I've got a multitrack drum recording with a bunch of different microphones that were at different distances and positions relative to the instruments. So what can happen is that when I add these signals all together, hopefully they add together in a good way, but you could also have the issue where they add together in a way where they actually start to cancel each other out and I lose some of the energy in the overall signal. That's when I've got destructive interference. And that's what I'm gonna try and avoid. Now it can be a very tedious process for you as a mixing engineer to try and figure out all this stuff by hand. So that's where a computer and a plugin comes in, where it can do it automatically for you in a much faster way and actually much more precise way. So let me play you back what I've got so far, my multi-track drum recording. I've even started to go ahead and mix it with some plugins, and this is what it sounds like. So the idea here is you're going to insert this plugin across all the channels in your multi-track recording. Go ahead here, pull up Polarity Maximizer from the company Audiomere. So it inserted across my mono tracks. Now I need to go into my stereo ones, insert it here. All right, so I've got Polarity Maximizer across all these tracks. The next thing I need to do is pick one of the channels to be the master. They're all going to send information about the signal on that channel to a single master, and the master then is going to do the analysis. So I've got my kick drum. I'll select over here to be my master. You'll see the new interface pops up where you can, the main button here is to click maximize. When you click maximize, then you have to play audio back so it can do the analysis across all the different signals. Now, what I'm going to do here, because I'm working with sample drums, I assume that this sample library, when they made the recordings, they did a pretty good job about this whole issue of phase cancellation, that kind of stuff. So let me go in and look and see what things are looking like, maybe on my my top and bottom snare mic. It looks like things are, even though there's a time delay, they're mostly going in the positive and negative directions around the same time. So why don't I do this? Before I do the analysis, I'm actually going to go in here and maybe on my top snare, let's introduce some phase cancellation and see if the Polarity Maximizer will solve the problem. So do this. All right. As soon as I flip the phase on my snare top, you can hear that there's the bottom end of the drum cancels out. All right, so I've introduced some phase cancellation into this recording. Let's see if the Polarity Maximizer will solve this problem. So I'll open it back up here. Next thing that I need to do, find where I want it to play it back from. Click Maximize on my master, play it back. Listening. All right, and it said it's done, and that it decided to optimize or to maximize the energy in the signal. It decided to flip the polarity on 6 different channels, and I gained a total of 7 dB by flipping the phase, and it increased the signal level. So let's go back through these channels and see where it decided to flip the phase, right? Didn't have to on the kick out. It should hear on the snare top. Yeah, you can see that it did flip the phase here, and that's because I had artificially introduced the phase issue on this channel. Let's see the other ones. So here, no phase change, none on these here. Let's get down. Okay, so it looks like for the overhead, it flipped the phase on that one. And then also here for the ambient near mono, but it did not do it for the ambient far microphone. So you can see how it decided that some of these channels need to flip the phase and other ones didn't. So I can go back in here and listen to it. Should have fixed the problem with the snare. I can bypass it. You can hear I lost that energy in my snare. Add it back in. So that's a Polarity Maximizer plugin. Hopefully you can see the advantages, what it can bring to your mixing. It can speed up this very tedious process, having to figure out, well, if you've got all these different tracks, what's the best way that they can all be added together. So definitely check out this plugin. It's from the company Audiomere. You can find it at audiomere.com. So make sure to check out this plugin, and I'll catch you guys next time.